This is Lynn from WisconsinGarden.com. And sometimes, no matter how well you weed your yard or your garden, there are going to be weeds that are invasive. That means that they just try to take over. And we have several of those on our property, and from time to time I'm going to have Rick get little snippets of me getting rid of them. Now sometimes you can dig them out. This is buckthorn. It's a very invasive species here in Wisconsin, and it has a very deep taproot that is a bright yellow. So when I dig it out, I know exactly what it is. See how nice and bright yellow that is? And see how, just for that little plant, how great that root system is. It has a very long taproot. So you don't want to let this get loose in your yard. And I learned at State Fair when we were talking to the horticulturist there that eventually this will get berries. The birds love the berries. They eat it. And it gives them diarrhea, which is nature's plan on spreading the seeds for this. So it could show up anywhere. It could, you know, it'll not be your fault that it's there. It's one of our bird friends betraying us, unfortunately.
Well, when we were at State Fair, I know you collected quite a few brochures. Mm-hmm. And how many different invasive species did they say we had just here in Wisconsin?
Oh,
I want to say it was like 100.
Mm-hmm.
Some.
Well, some were, you know, totally bad. You were supposed to call and let them know if you find it in somebody's, if you find it even along the roadside, and let the Department of Agriculture know about it so they can take care of it. And some of it is just pesty. Like, we have bindweed, and we've pulled it all out at the moment. I've talked about it before. It's from the Morning Glory family. It has little leaves on it, and it just binds everything up. It just twirls around everything, and it's very annoying. It chokes out your beautiful flowers. Another one, of course, is grapevine. Now, grapevines, again, the birds like to spread the grapevines around. And of course, you know, they are vines, so they will climb anywhere they can. When we bought this house, there were grapevines growing up into the trees, and they pretty much screened the house from the road. They were that prolific. Now, sometimes you plant something thinking it's going to be beautiful, and it turns out to just take over. And we're digging out a plant that I thought was going to be lovely, but it turns out it's too invasive for our liking. It's called gooseneck loosestrife, which has a very unique flower head on it that kind of bends over. It's very pretty, but it's just too invasive for us. And when we had our wood fence up, it was fine because that would have kept it where it belonged, but since our wood berm is gone, we need to keep in mind where it will go. So our job today is to get it out of here.
Kind of like lilies of the valley.
Kind of like that, except not quite as bad. At least not yet.
So this is the area that you're going to pull out?
This entire area here, yes. And just to give you an idea of what it looks like underneath, I have sprayed this once already with Roundup. Yes, I use Roundup.
Deep roots?
On occasion. They're not really deep, they're just, once you get under them, you'll see. Maybe not. There we go. All right, so you see what kind of roots we're going for, and you see that they are very aggressive. And just with us digging these out, it will be helpful, but it's something that I'll have to keep after all next summer.
And what are you putting in here now?
Well, we're going to be putting in, for one thing, a holly bush. It's a blue flowered holly bush, which will be gorgeous in the winter and obviously in the fall. So we had one that didn't quite make it this summer. It made it through last winter, but it didn't make it through this summer when it was so hot. So that's one of the things. And then maybe some bulbs, and who knows what else.
Well, you're also adding two other holly bushes over on the other side of behind you there.
That's right. That's right.
And then you have a delphinium, and then you have two more Russian sage, right?
Correct. Yes.
And then, of course, bulbs. Hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of bulbs.
Right. So these we bought in our fall sale at our garden center. So this is a great time to go shopping.
The garden bargains.
Yep.
Okay, well, let's get digging.
Let's get digging. They have red stems so you can find them.
You finding the oil or diamonds yet?
No, none of those yet.
Arrowheads?
No, not either.
Dinosaur bones?
There's a lot of loose strike here, though. Well, we've gone about 15 feet so far. We got just this little bit left, and then that'll be our first attempt of getting rid of the gooseneck loose stripe that I'm sorry I put in here. But the lilies will love it, and whatever we put here will love it. So it's just a matter of keeping after it and making sure it doesn't come back.
Let me find if you find any old bones.
Indeed, or arrowheads. Pot of gold. Oops. I'm gonna have to dig that one a little bit more. Okay, I'm planting the Russian sage. Someone asked how big a hole should be. It should be twice as big as the plant that you're gonna put in and 2 inches deeper. That gives some growing space. And you want it to be about this height so that it's even when you get done. It's even with the landscape. Okay. And the reason you want it to be bigger is so that it has roots, if the roots can easily spread out.
And again, if it's root bound at the base, then you just
right.
kind of
you kind of work your it. Fingers around in there, and this one's not too bad. But see, now all of the loose soil is around so that it can easily shoot out new roots and take hold. And the bees are after it already. It smells good. Delphinium with this beautiful blue.
And how big do those get?
Oh, they'll get about up to 3 feet tall, but slender. Up the soil so it's nice and crumbly.
Okay.
firm it in. Do not step on it though. You want the water to be able to go down easily when you water it. You just don't want it falling over. One of our baby hollies. This is our last one. This is the big holly, and that'll make three hollies, three Russian sages, one delphinium, and I think that's it. And then we moved some big sedums that were already in bloom, and then some tip flower to go in between the sedums. So we just moved those around from what we had. So the last holly's going in now.
What I like about these hollies is they don't have thorns. They do have thorns, but they're soft. The leaves are probably thornier than the stems.
Right, the ends of the leaves are prickly. But they have blueberries. Not blueberries, but blueberries.
So, next job is watering.
Next job is watering. And then Mother Nature will take over. Bye for now.